Dear student, welcome to this session of class 5 history. And in my previous video, I had already explained you about these diagrams, if you remember. And today I will start the lesson. Okay, so evolution of transport, that is how the transport system evolved. Okay. In transport, what is the most important thing? That is the wheel. Okay. While riding a cycle, you must have noticed that how the wheel moves. Okay. In all the forms of transport, whether it is by car or truck or bus or rail. Okay. In everything, you will see that the wheel is used. Okay. So, in evolution of transport, the first thing is that how man invented the wheel. Okay, wheel plays. Okay, over here you can see that this man, how he invented this wheel. Okay, so first let's see. The evolution of transport, just like the evolution of humankind, has gone through many hits and trials as it has evolved through time. Okay, so it was not a one day process. It took many years. Okay, for the wheel to be developed and for the evolution of transport. Okay, it was just like a slow process as human being evolved. Okay, already in the Stone Age, we studied evolution of human beings. Okay, how from ape-like structure, the man developed into present human form. And so it was a long process. Throughout history, man has slowly and painstakingly evolved the means of transport to where it is today. Okay, so if we see the history past, then the evolution of transport was a slow process and painstakingly. Painstakingly means very difficult, and let me see the word meaning. It is also given at the back. Okay, painstakingly. Yes, over here it is given. See, painstaking, done with great care. Okay, done with great care, evolved the means of transport to where it is today. Many modes of transport have evolved and many more have gone extinct. Okay, many modes of transport. We know that nowadays generally four modes of transport are there. That is roadways, railways, waterways and airways. Okay, these are the four modes of transport. So many modes of transport have evolved and many more have gone extinct. Okay, extinct means now those means of transport is no more used. Earlier, for example, bullock cart. Okay, bullock cart or any cart which was drawn by animals. But nowadays, now instead of those animals, now we are using machines for like vehicles, car, truck, bus. Okay, for so those bullock cart or carts drawn by animals are normally becoming extinct. In villages still they are used, but in towns you will not see bullock carts and all such things. With the expansion of the human understanding and culture, the modes of transport have developed as well. Okay, so you know that first thing was bicycle. After bicycle, then vehicles, motor vehicles were made. Then men wanted to go fast, and so Wright brother invented the aeroplane, and James Watt invented the steam engine. Okay, and nowadays we are talking about inventing supersonic. Okay, we can travel even faster than the sound. So still more and more inventions and developments are done in the field of transport. So the first thing was invention of wheel and beginning of transport. Okay, the first thing is invention of wheel, how this wheel was invented. So in the early times there was no wheel and no vehicle. Okay, so men used to walk. Okay, long distance. There was no wheel, no vehicle. Early humans had to walk long distance. They had to carry the load and the dead animals on their back. You can see this gentleman carrying this pig on his back, which is very heavy. Okay, and so it was not easy to travel. Then they also used animals like horses, donkeys, bullocks for carrying heavy loads. This was when domestication of animals started, when people started domesticating animals. So these are called donkeys, horses, bullocks. They are called what we call pack animals for carrying heavy loads. So these animals were used for carrying heavy loads, but they took a lot of time. With the passage of time, they developed raft and sledges to carry heavy things. This is a raft and this is a sledge. Okay, so these are also used for moving, for carrying loads. Okay. Then the raft was a platform of straight logs that could float on water. Okay, this was used for as a boat. Okay, in the rivers or in lake. Okay, for carrying the things from one bank to the other bank. Okay, so raft and sledge is mostly used in what we call hilly areas or in snowy regions. Then sledges were the carts made up of logs. Okay, over here. You can see round logs of trees. They could move on smooth ground only. Okay, that is in sloping land. Then sledges were the carts. Okay. Then sometimes later, the early humans realized that round logs of wood could move easily on the ground. Okay, so this gentleman, when he was carrying this load on his back, it was very tiring. So second, he tamed animal like horse, and so with the help of the horse, he carried this pig on the back of the horse. Then he thought sometimes that if he can use a raft or a sledge like this. Okay, but it was also not easy. So this gentleman, finally he thought of making a will, because he realized that round logs of wood could move easily on the ground. So this is how the invention of wheel took place. The invention of the wheel appeared in the late Neolithic age, around 3500 BC. That idea was converted into the invention of the wheel. It was a major milestone in the history of human development. It is believed that the first wheel was made by cutting logs into round. Okay, you can see that how this log was cut, okay, into a round wheel. The invention of the wheel made the land travel easier and faster. Okay, today we will discuss up to here. In the next video, then again, I will continue from here. Till then, you see the video and write the inside questions and prepare well for your next exam. Okay, thank you. Take care. Bye.